Good morning, January 7th, 2023, and I have a short video about the DatScan. Really hard to find anything on the internet that normal, non-medical human beings can decipher and look at to show what exactly is going on. But I was requesting my videos, my data and video imaging from IU Health to take to Mayo in a month and 2 days. And I looked at it. I didn't think I'd have access to it. Normally they have a weird FIN files or BIN files, and you don't have access to this type of stuff. And I opened it up, and on a website I was able to view it. So let me show you exactly. I spent 3 or 4 days trying to find the data for it, to find normal and abnormal. But I found it. Let me show you real quick. So if you remember here on my screenshot, it shows the call date is actually normal, but the putamen is not. Okay, so just remember that call date was normal for myself, and the putamen activity was actually absent. How did they do this? They put some liquid in you, stops this, stops that, and then they look at you. So found a picture online. I'll give some references in the comments. National Institute of Health. If you look at this picture, it shows looking at the front of the head to the back, front of the brain to the back, from left to right on my screen, the call date is the forward most part of what we're looking at, in this case in the red. And the putamen is behind it. So when you're looking top down, call date's front, putamen's the back, and it actually forms, when you look at it top down, it looks like a comma. Opposite directions on both sides of the brain, but a long comma, very broad but long, and that's what we're looking for. Okay, so it took me a while to actually find some diagrams, because they get into the caudate nucleus and gets a little more confusing. So what does that normally look like? Well, this one, a normal scan on the left, normal caudate and putamen comma shaped, right? Normal, longish. Of course, you see a little abnormal there, but if we go to another one, screenshot, I zoom in, you can see the top left is actually the normal. You can see the call date in the front, top of the front of the face is towards the top of the screen, and then the putamen's more narrowing of the comma shape. And then you got three other B, C, and D of abnormal spec images of imaging. It took a while to find this image that something actually shows normal. I think I spent 2.5 days looking for something like this. Not very easy. Okay, so there are a few things on here, images to show. Here goes another abnormal with a patient with MSA, right? You can see putamen is still there. Call date is actually inactive. You don't see really anything as far as a comma shaped. And on this one, you actually see the right side, on the right side of the image is nice and colorful, and the left one is shrinking. So I imagine this person has issues of both the putamen and the call date. So show you my imaging that I have on mine, the website, which is this one. So I downloaded the documents, and first imaging it had was the test was going around and around and around. Kind of hard to describe this, but very blurry. I'm not sure what this was looking at. I'm sure there's some diagnostic relevance for that. And then we look at top down. So looking straight down those little images we're doing on the internet. Top down, like someone's up above me on the ceiling. That's what we're looking at. Zooms in, goes through the brain, and there you can see the call date, but you don't see putamen activity. There's no comma shaped, just circular. Right? I can keep zooming in and out. You can see my nose up there, right? Cranial cavities and stuff. So again, there goes the putamen. I'm sorry, there goes the call date, but there's no comma shaped putamen in there. And then this one is really the more glaring of the two, right? Obviously, they highlighted something there for diagnostic criteria, but, they gave me a diagnosis. They gave me, I drunk something to stop some type of thing happening in my brain. I can't remember what it was. Thyroid, I think it was. And then they gave me a nuclear medicine to highlight this area. So you can see on here, again, the caudate is both are active. It looks the same on both sides to me. Of course, I'm not a medical expert, but it looks pretty good on both sides. But you don't see the comma shape. You just see circles here. So the putamen is not actually, has no activity. And I believe this imaging here from left to right, top down, is the machine going around in circles. So again, it's notating that, hey, I don't know which side the front of the face would be. I'm going to imagine this would be on the right hand side of the screen towards the colors would be the front of the face, because that's closest to where the caudate would be, and the putamen should be behind it. Matter of fact, I think there is some black area there, but that's, you know, it's showing it from a side view, and I think it's from the right side of my face is what this view would be. So again, you know, pretty good, interesting images they have on here. You know, the DatScan cannot differentiate between most, you know, it can't differentiate everything and say, hey, you specifically have this. And that's why the scan that I had, you know, said literally it's, you know, since these things are absent, it is consistent with, you know, one of these few diseases, very few diseases. So now they have to use other diagnostic clinical criteria to narrow that down. So I thought that was really, really, really interesting, how you're able to actually see these images and what it actually looks like. Most people don't get to see these things, and let alone have access to them. And just, you know, just because I'm transferring to the Mayo Clinic, I can actually do it. So, short video. Just want to show you guys what that looks like. And you know, it's interesting. at least I got half of what I need to keep going here. But still, you know, I have more videos to come, more topics. If you enjoy what I do, enjoy this type of data, you know, me sharing what I have, please give me a like and subscribe. Just trying to show others, you know, if you ever had your diagnostic, you know, material, you can look at the same thing, and, you know, every little bit helps. So I appreciate you, and I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye.